My back has gone out again. I don't know what we're going to do about it. Definitely have a weak back. Praise the Lord. Our position, believing God and defying the devil. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. James 4:7. It is a gracious thing to be humbled under the loving, chastening hand of God. But when the devil starts tampering with you, dare to resist him. Brethren, God never meant for us to be kicked around like a football. I stand for believing in God and defying the devil. And our God loves that kind of courage. It is for us to trust fully in the Lord Jesus. This is the only way in which we can conquer fear and live in blessed victory. I have had times in my life and ministry when the burdens and pressures seem to be too much. At these times, it seems that even in prayer, it is impossible to rise above the load. More than once, my faith has seemed to have been imparted directly from heaven. The Lord has enabled me to claim all that I needed for body, soul, and spirit. Boy, don't I feel like that now. On my knees, I have been given freedom and strength to pray. Now, Lord, I've had enough of this. I refuse to take any more of this heaviness and oppression. This does not come from God. This comes from the enemy, the devil. Lord, in Jesus' name, I will not take it any longer. Though Jesus Christ, I am victor. Will God answer? At these times, great burdens have just melted all at once. As the burden rolls away, he answers, Child, I have waited long to hear you confess that Jesus is victor, and in him you overcome. You know, to a certain degree, I agree. To a certain extent, I agree with this idea of an affirmation, but with so much that's distorted nowadays, I resist the declarations that most people use in pride when they just simply say, oh, I'm not going to take it anymore, devil, you get back, you do this, you do that, and I'm going to tell you how to do it, and I'm going to get you there, and you're going to go there, and it's going to happen because, you know what, I got the power, and I got the authority, and Jesus gave it to me, and I'm going to go tell it. I don't think so. I do think that there is, in the life of Jesus, as we look at it, a certain amount of truth to declaring what God is doing and what God's word is, but not in doing it in our own authority and what we claim or repeat simply because it fits for us but doesn't fit in the context of Scripture. Jesus, when he quoted anything from Scripture, was always in the reality of how it applied to that circumstance or situation. When I hear people use things that says, with commands, I find them more exercising kind of a lucky charm idea than a reality of God is still the one doing it. So for me, yeah, you know, I agree that we have to resist the devil and that we have to exercise our faith in letting God move in a way that we can't do for ourselves. But I also believe that it's God that does it and not we ourselves. That we do not have that capability because we can't see what we're fighting. We don't know who it is and we don't know what it is half the time. So I would rather that God move and choose to do so on my behalf than for me to act without him and possibly react to something I have no idea of what is going on. But maybe that's me. How the Lord may lead you is why we have emotionals and devotionals. Whatsoever the Lord tells you to do, that you should do.